Let's talk about fandoms. What's strange about fandoms for me is that I didn't get into it until very recently, actually. I mean, I've watched TV series for quite some time, but I never get into the whole fan culture thing. And I think it has to a degree to do with the fact that I grew up without television. There wasn't a TV in our house until I was about 12 or 13, I don't really remember when. And so as a kid, I didn't watch TV at home. We had books and games and stuff, and I watched TV at my grandma's, and I watched a lot of TV at my grandma's, but it wasn't those weekends or weeks at my grandma's weren't enough to really get me into certain series. And she also, they monitored what I was watching, so I had stacks and stacks of VHS tapes that they recorded for me with stuff they thought was good for kids, and it was great stuff, but it's not, it weren't series that inspire major fandom. It was German children's TV with little puppets, and that's not the stuff that fandoms are made of, I guess. And then over the years, I guess because I didn't have it for so long, I got crazy into TV series, and I get really, it doesn't take long for me to get excited about TV series and movies and books. It's nothing that I would identify with a fandom. The first thing of that sort that I got into, I guess, was Harry Potter, when my dad gave me the books when I was 10 or 12. I love them. I love the books. The movies are okay, I guess, but Harry doesn't look right in the movies. He's just not the way I pictured my Harry. Also because the German cover art is completely different from the English or the American one. I saw that kid with the red yellow glasses in my head when I read the books, and not, you know, Daniel Radcliffe. And the second thing that came very soon after was Lord of the Rings, which was more of an accident because I had just turned 12 and I wanted to go see a movie that was ages 12 or up. It was amazing. It was the start of an obsession. And I love that movie until today. And then I got the books, and the books are sort of underwhelming, I guess. There is a lot of description, and as much as I love the story, there's only so much flora and fauna that I can take. Doctor Who and Sherlock. And with Doctor Who, I don't really know how I got into Doctor Who, because it's not a thing in Germany, not at all. It is on TV now, but on some very abstruse pay TV station that I don't even know I could get if I wanted to. I don't know how I got into it. I just did, and I loved it. I had no one to share it with me, and that was really frustrating for quite some time, because I was so excited about it. And there was David Tennant. My doctor is number 10, of course. I just told my friend Becky, you know, there's this TV show and you gotta watch it with me, and if you don't, I'm gonna hate you forever. And she did, and now she's as much into it as I am, which is amazing. Yeah, and then there was Sherlock, which I am equally concerned about as Christina, because I just want to see the third series, and I can't even think about it right now. So in the meantime, I'm watching lots and lots of other TV series that don't really mean anything, and that I get excited about in the moment, and as soon as they're over, I'm like, no, you know, that's it. Goodbye. Is there anything else? I don't know. I'm afraid I forgot something, and I'm gonna slap myself when I edit this. I don't even have any stuff. I would love to go and have my sonic screwdriver, but I don't even have that. I have a stapler. That's neither sonic nor exciting. Alright, that's it from me. Bye-bye. Thing until about a couple of months. I don't know, a couple of months. TH. until a couple of months ago.